In this training topic, we're going to learn about some key behaviours of ARM's Cortex-A, R and M processors. So what do we mean by behaviours? Well, let's start by taking a step back. So Cortex processors are all built on the ARM architecture, which says that we have a concept of simple sequential execution, where each instruction has to fully complete before the next one. This is a theoretical model. And in practice, you would never design a processor to work like this, as it would be incredibly inefficient. However, what the architecture says is that when you design a processor, you must keep to this principle of simple sequential execution. So Cortex processors can do lots of different optimizations, so long as the final results from your optimized code are the same as what the final results would be if the code ran with the simple sequential execution model. So this topic is not so much about what you're allowed to do in the architecture, but rather it gives you some examples of what you can do in a typical implementation using the optimization behaviors that are included in the Cortex processors. And we're doing this because what we care about as hardware engineers when we're looking at our simulations is understanding what we're seeing. And learning about the optimizations that the processors can perform helps us do that.